On air.
WWCU Cullowhee.
Online.
WWCUFM.com.
Power 90.5.
Thank you.
Are we on Earth? Are we a hologram? Where does the darkness end? Do you want to believe anything is possible on Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, the craziest show in the mountains? Tune in to WWCU FM every Sunday evening from 6 to 8 p.m. for your favorite conspiracies. The answer to 1984 is Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies.
Rock of the Week. Power 90.5.
This is Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, the craziest show in the mountains, only on WWCU-FM Cullowhee. I'm Manny Jones. Let me take you into a world where anything is possible if you want to believe. Don't touch that dial, because all the Mannies know the secrets on 90.5. WWCU is Western Carolina University. From the campus of Western Carolina University in Cullowhee, it's time for the craziest show in the mountains. I'm talking none other than Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, broadcasting throughout Jackson and Haywood County in beautiful Western North Carolina and worldwide on WWCUFM.com. I'm Manny Jones, your host. Things are about to get crazy. We'll be on a fantastic Sunday, April 7th, 2019. It's been a good Sunday for me myself. Earlier today, I was announcing a softball game. Luckily, that game wrapped up before the storm clouds out here started a brewing. Stay dry, Western Carolina. Stay dry. So in the first hour of last week's program, I discussed CIA conspiracies such as Northwoods, MK Ultra, and what else have you. But today, the first hour of today's show will focus on feedback from last week. Last week's transmission, again, we discussed CIA conspiracies in the first hour, and Dan from The Edge, who has a great show you can listen in on Thursdays from 8 to 10 p.m., he sent in a story about MK Ultra, which was a CIA mind control program. We will be talking about that and more, along with a YouTube video I found. Now, I was browsing Reddit during last week's show, and I found a conspiracy about how the Illuminati has coded time travel through pi. And I said there's a video there, and I might watch it. I did. And you will hear what is in that video in the first hour. And the second hour will focus again on current news events, such as how the president, or Orange Man as some might call him, has claimed that wind turbines have caused cancer, along with that Richard Nixon might have had a role in the fall of the Soviet Union, reptilians and dinosaurs could be related, and the Raelians have asked the United Nations to develop a diplomatic plan for when extraterrestrials arrive. it makes me wonder if they will have a plan, if they had a plan actually for when ET needed to phone home. If you're looking into the studio webcam on WWCUFM.com, my headphones are a little busted. The left side of my headphones are just fine, but the right side has broken off. Obviously, there is only one conclusion that I must come to. The Illuminati was breaking my headphones, so I can't hear myself on the radio. That's their goal. The left side works just fine, though. So I'll keep going. I guess this right one, I could put it up. Maybe a little bit like Mickey Mouse. Maybe I'll get famous when I have myself look like Mickey Mouse, I guess. Oh, hi there, everybody. It's Manny from Manny's Rockin Conspiracies. You guys ready to hear some conspiracies? But I hope you're having a fantastic Sunday. Thank you for tuning in with me. Let's kick the show off right with some good music. I want to feel good when I start a show, you know? You always want to feel good every day. You want to feel good. Always go out and just feel amazing. What better song to play than Gorillaz' Feel Good, Inc.? You're tuned in to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on 90.5. WWCU is Western Carolina University. We are the shaking. Monsters by Matchbook Romance here on Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, the craziest show in the mountains, broadcasting on 90.5 throughout Jackson and Haywood counties and worldwide on WWCUFM.com. I'm Manny Jones. You're tuned in again to the craziest show in the mountains. So if you are just tuning in, I said in the last segment that the first hour is going to be a feedback on what happened last week. So let's start with MKUltra. If you don't know what MKUltra was, what I'm talking about, MKUltra was a mind control program ran by the Central Intelligence Agency for about 20 years. And the goal of this experiment was to see if... The goal of the project was to see if scientists could use LSD, sleeping drugs, and electroshock therapy to control people. There's not much record of what happened, though what has been declassified by the CIA, it was pretty big. Dan from The Edge sent me this story from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, the True North, about a lawsuit against Quebec and Canadian governments over MKUltra. Now, this story is a little outdated. It was back in March of 2018. So I was trying to find the most relevant, and I could not find it. Though, if it does come up, I will happily talk about it. So here's what I found about this. There was a doctor. Now, if I could find the article, I don't know where the article is. Where is it? MKUltra Canada lawsuit. There we go. I think I found it now. Here we go. So this was being prepared by Survivors Allied Against Government Abuse. And it would sue several organizations who were guilty of or complicit in the brainwashing experiments that took place in Montreal's Allen Memorial Hospital and the Douglas Hospital through the 40s, 50s, and 60s. Now these experiments were perpetrated by Scottish psychiatrist Ewen Cameron, who was being financed by the CIA and, like I said earlier, subjected patients to electroshock treatments, experimental drugs, in an attempt to depattern or basically wipe the memory of patients and then reprogram them. Now, here was some testimony from some of the patients. This is from Marlene Levinson, whose aunt was admitted to the facility. These were innocent people that went in for mild depression. They came out completely ravaged and their life was ruined. And apparently, Cameron had hoped his experiments would cure patients' illnesses by erasing certain memories and reprogramming their brains. However, it had a very adverse effect. Levinson actually said that her aunt could no longer care for herself, and she hated being touched after the experiment. Another case that was given was by Angela Bardosh. Her mother, Nancy Layton, had showed the news company that reported on this, that was a letter from her mother that said, "They destroyed many parts of me. I am lucky to be alive." Bardosh said her mother went to the facility at age 18 due to depression, and Bardosh claims that her mother's time as a patient of Project MKUltra ruined her life. And within 6 months of Cameron's treatment on her mother had developed acute schizophrenia. Now, what do you think? Do you think that these families of former patients have the right to sue the governments of Quebec, and Canada over mind control? Why don't you let me know at 828-227-7173. Got any conspiracy for me to talk about? Maybe even a request. 828-227-7173. Queued up is Shot in the Dark by Ozzy Osbourne. You're listening to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies only on 90.5. WWCU is Western Carolina University.
On air. WWCU Colorway. Online. WWCUFM.com. Power.
Welcome back to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, broadcasting throughout Jackson and Haywood counties on 90.5. WWCU is Western Carolina University and worldwide on WWCUFM.com. I'm Manny Jones. Now, in the previous segment, I discussed how a lawsuit was going forth against the governments of Quebec and Canada about MKUltra. Well, we're going to go a little bit away from that. Last week, during the second hour of this program, I mentioned a video about virtual time travel and apparently how it's coded by the Illuminati. The video was, no kidding, called "The Illuminati Made Pi What It Is." So, before the show, I decided I would go out and watch it. So, it's quite odd, and it starts with saying that every first letter on the seal of the U.S. dollar, specifically the dollar bill, I want to see if I have one real quick, maybe I can go along with this. Oh, I do! It's the Illuminati shell money, as they say. All right, so if you look on the back of your dollar bill, there is a seal that shows a pyramid, and it leads us to the eye of God. Now, they say that if you have to do this in a certain way, if you rearrange the letters of the first letter or the whatever letter it is, of the seals, you get Masons. Look at an example. Seclorum, M, Anuit, A, S, Novus, S, O, Ordo, N, Mason. So you get that on the dollar bill. And the one rumor that I have always heard, mainly from people like Alex Jones, is that if somewhere on the dollar bill is the first, the $1 bill it is Moloch, the owl god, that is apparently worshipped at the Bohemian Grove by the Bohemian Club. Rumor has it that Ronald Reagan's been there, Richard Nixon's been there, a whole bunch of people have apparently been there. So back to the video. It says that it spells Mason, but that it also spells out pi. It's some odd math that I was very confused by. There wasn't much for me to go off of, but the conspiracy theories that are involving gematria or numerology in general, perhaps the most odd ones out there, and what interest me the most. I remember years before I started this show, there was a conspiracy led by some theorists online, because there are some theorists that believe that everything is a conspiracy. They were saying that Dale Earnhardt, who tragically passed away at the 2001 Daytona 500 when he crashed into the wall, was all an Illuminati set up that he did not die. Now, how they figured this out, you might be asking, is simple. They claimed that Dale Earnhardt equals 111, and that New York also equals 111. How do they connect? I don't really know. And how apparently that Jeff Gordon, the last name Gordon, equals 56, like Satan. So I guess NASCAR is satanic? I don't know. Again, this is not my viewpoint. These are viewpoints of people online. But once again, hashtag back to the video. It did mention some fact about Easter Island, which is off the coast of Chile, Giza in Egypt, and plenty of other ancient cities or ancient sites are aligned in a circle. Because Illuminati, I guess. He ends his math by saying it could be random nonsense, which I don't know what you think. It sounds like that. Or it could be, this is his words, ladies and gentlemen, it could be a simulation. A time-traveling one that allows us to rewrite history with every iteration, or there are time travelers among us, and we apparently travel back in time, but to organize information for a time traveler, it would have to be a time traveler rewriting time. It's just very confusing, but I guess this is what I get for going down the rabbit hole of conspiracies. Now, if this is a simulation, apparently, where I can rewrite time, could I rewrite time back to the SoCon Championships and have Western Carolina win in the SoCon tournament? I don't know. But that's a possibility, though. Oh, the possible dimensions, the possible possibilities. If you're curious about any conspiracy on this program, don't be afraid to give me a call at 828-227-7173. Let me know what you think. Deutschland by the German industrial band Rammstein, here on the craziest show in the mountains, Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on 90.5 WWCU. Is Western Carolina University. Apologies if Deutschland went down further and came back. The magic of live radio, anything can happen, especially on the craziest show in the mountains, because the answer to 1984 is not 1776. It's Manny's Rockin' Conspiracy. So, I've been talking about the CIA in the first hour of my previous two shows, and if there's one thing I love is aliens and conspiracies, hence why I'm wearing an alien shirt right now in studio. It's pretty fabulous, I think. It's pretty fabulous. So, apparently, the CIA and former Russian president Dmitry Medvedev has proved that aliens and UFOs exist. Now, this is different than what I've always expected. I know from my friend Isaac, who hopefully is tuning in beautiful Alabama. He's from the Soviet Union, so he'll tell me for the record that the Soviet Union and Russia is a very secretive place. But let's see this real quick. In January 2 years ago, in 3 years actually, 2016, the CIA released thousands of declassified documents about UFOs. These documents date back to the 1940s to the 1960s. The CIA have always denied having information on aliens, though in 2012 they did release proof that Area 51 existed. Now, former President Dmitry Medvedev has claimed to know of the existence of aliens. He actually has prepared a statement to the United States claiming that if they do not tell the world what the U.S. knows, then Russia will. This is pretty different. I know this is Russia, so we should be skeptical, but think about it like this. Russia probably has kept their UFO encounters very well documented, but What would Russia gain, actually, or what would the world gain if Russia started pressuring the Western world to tell the truth? Of course, he could be joking, but apparently the CIA has claimed it and Dmitry Medvedev has claimed it. What do you think? Do you think aliens exist? Why don't you give me a call on your thoughts at 828-227-7173. Again, 828-227-7173. I want to give a quick shout out to some listeners, one of which is my Uncle Phil, my cousin Ben, listening in beautiful Florida. Florida's a beautiful state, but it is a crazy one indeed. That's why you see a lot of Florida Man stories out there. I am not behind the Florida Man stories. Florida Man E is more like it. And in honor of talking about aliens, that is, I have a fitting song. It would be Aliens Exist by Blink-182. One of their members actually left Blink-182 to find aliens. So this song is pretty fitting. Again, Aliens Exist by Blink-182 here on Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies. On 90.5 WWCU is Western Carolina University.
Friends, this is Bobby from the Universal Social Media Life Insurance Company of Biloxi, Mississippi. It happens every day. A person gets busy texting and driving and bam, they're gone. A friend is walking down the sidewalk, swapping pictures on social media, steps into the crosswalk and splat, hit by a bus. What will their loved ones do? Now, for less than the cost of insuring your smartphone, you can have a Universal Social Media Life Insurance policy in case you get consumed while texting or being on social media. It's time to provide your family the peace of mind they deserve in case you do something stupid like texting and driving. For just pennies a day, isn't it time you thought about something else besides your smartphone? Do something smart today. Call me at the Universal Social Media Life Insurance Company of Biloxi, Mississippi. Not available at any authorized insurance agent in any state. This public service message brought to you by Power 90.5.
O'clock, Numa.
Hello?
Here on Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies.
Eu un haiduc și te rog, iubirea mea primește fericirea.
The first hour is wrapped up. We talked about CIA conspiracies and what have not. This hour, we're focusing on current news in the world of the conspiracies and the paranormal. You might be wondering what I have up in queue for this hour. It's a variety of news stories. But I think the first one that I think is the most pressing is about the Raelians. Now, what exactly are the Raelians? This is your first time hearing about the Raelians. Let me give you a brief synopsis. The Raelianism, is a religion that was founded by Claude Vauhan, or Rael, and it teaches that all life on Earth was scientifically created by a species of humanoid extraterrestrials called the Elohim. And members of the species apparently appear human when having personal contacts with the descendants of the human that they made. They purposely misinformed every humanity that they were angels, cherubim, or gods. And Raelians believe that the messages of Buddha, Jesus, and Muhammad are prophets of the Elohim who informed humans of each era. And the founder of Raelism believed that the final message of the Elohim and that its purpose is to inform the world about Elohim, and that if humans become aware and peaceful enough, they wish to be welcomed by them. Them meaning the aliens. They had some controversy back in 2002 when their company Clone Aid, which was developed to do human cloning, cloned the first human baby. Though few believe it, it attracted major national attention and caused much more attention granted to the Raelians. So, what have the Raelians done exactly? Well, they asked the United Nations to develop a diplomatic plan for when extraterrestrials arrive. They released a press release last Tuesday. In a statement, they announced that the Raelians have been in negotiations for the past year with an unnamed nation that will allow the religious order to build their long-proposed safe space for extraterrestrials. With that groundbreaking coming in, also, is this an embassy? Who is going to be the embassy of the human race to these aliens? That's a good question. They have declared that it is now time for the United Nations to get involved. They are hoping for the creation of an international conference in which countries that are participating in this conference can discuss a new protocol to the Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations in the case that ET visitors visit Earth. And they cite what is a growing number of amount of interest from a number of nations that are yearning to speak freely about aliens. And they express confidence that the UN will hear out and acknowledge the growing number of people who care for a proper and formal welcome of an outworldly civilization. They've also lambasted other countries, saying, "We must offset such an outdated and belligerent position relating to people, to countries that may foster fear of an alien invasion." The UN may, I don't know if the UN will respond, but what do you think? Should there be a UN plan for the arrival of aliens? Why don't you let me know at 828-227-7173. Again, 828-227-7173. Coming up next in this hour, wind turbines could, apparently to Donald Trump, cause cancer. There is brainwashing, apparently is real. Richard Nixon may have had a role in the fall of the Soviet Union. Reptilians and dinosaurs could be related. So does that mean, who's a dinosaur then? Is the Illuminati dinosaurs? That's all that and more on the craziest show in the mountains. Queued up is America by the German industrial man Rammstein. Because simply put, we're all living in America. Ich wunderbar. You're listening to Manny's Rockin Conspiracies on WWCU FM, the broadcast service of Western Carolina University 90.5. The Beautiful People by Marilyn Manson from his 1997 album, Antichrist Superstar, here on the craziest show in the mountains, Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies. Still going strong with a partly broken headphones. Want to give a quick shout out to, I believe, the newest member of this audience here. Thank you for tuning in as well. But my grandmother texted me telling me that her cat Otis, whenever she puts on my show, which has a studio webcam on WWCUFM.com, her cat will sit in front of the computer and watch me on the webcam. So I want to give a quick thanks to Otis the cat in Fayetteville, North Carolina, for tuning in to the craziest show in the mountains. The first time I've had a feline listener. And thanks to my Uncle Ray and Uncle Ray listening out there with Janice and my good friend Char in the mountainous region of New Mexico. But let's get into perhaps the newest conspiracy that I just want to talk about. Now, let me just clarify before I go into the segment that I am not taking any side in the political spectrum here. I am just talking about a very odd conspiracy relating to Mr. Donald Trump. The president, or some would say the orange man. Now, Mr. Trump made a claim at a Republican fundraiser in Washington, D.C., that the noise from wind turbines apparently causes cancer. As he said, if you have a windmill anywhere near your house, congratulations, your house just went down 75% in value. And they say the noise causes cancer. You tell me that one, okay? And the thing makes so much, and of course, oh, why did I do that? Come on, computer. The thing makes so much noise, and of course, it's like a graveyard for birds. If you love birds, you never want to walk under a windmill again. Now, where is Mr. Trump getting this claim? He's getting it from Simon Chapman, a professor in public health at the University of Sydney in the land down under in Australia. In 2012, he wrote an article which reviewed stories of people who had illnesses blamed on turbines. His suggestion was that the illnesses, while they were real, they were not attributable to the turbines, but instead were psychogenic, which means that they were caused by anxiety and unrest. A lot of cases like that, they are caused by anxiety. Mr. Trump has had a fight with wind turbines. This is not his first battle. In February, he lost a long-running legal battle with the Scottish government because they put a wind farm near one of his golf courses. He had lost and had to pay legal bills for himself and the Scottish government. Wind turbines causing cancer, though, now that is an interesting claim for sure. But what do you think? Do you think that I think this could be the vaccines cause autism sort of conspiracy? But what do you think? Let me know at 828-227-7173. Again, 828-227-7173. Queued up next is Wicked Garden by the Stone Temple Pilots. You're listening to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on 90.5 WWCU is Western Carolina University.
Interested in the alternative rock sounds of different and cutting-edge bands? The Edge with Dan. Playing unique music from classic and upcoming artists on Thursday nights from 8 to 10 p.m. The Edge with Dan, only on WWCU FM, the broadcast service of Western Carolina University. Anything can happen on The Edge.
Four decades of rock.
This is Neil Young.
Hi, this is Peter Frampton.
This is Bruce Springsteen.
Halloween's Rock Station.
Power 90.5.
Now get the guns, the drugs. From my generation, I'll take the fall. The state, and across the nation. And it's a sin. The guns, the freaks, the fraud. They're messing with me.
Welcome back to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, broadcasted throughout Jackson, Haywood counties, and worldwide on WWCUFM.com. That theme song always gets me going. That was the third theme song I used on this program, and that was the old Raw theme song from years and years ago. Because tonight is the grandest stage of them all, WrestleMania. Big wrestling fan over here. But we're not here to talk about wrestling conspiracies, though there is one that I may touch up on later in the program. So here's an interesting one. Richard Nixon. You don't know who he was. Richard Nixon was the president years and years ago. He was very controversial. One of his more controversial things was the Watergate scandal, in which several associates broke into the Watergate complex, which was where the DNC was housed. Nixon resigned amidst definite impeachment. However, from what this article is saying, he had a major role in the downfall of the Soviet Union. He came back, encouraged by Ronald Reagan, starting from 1985 after staying home in San Clemente, California. He became a major international diplomat. One event that shows just how much Nixon did was on March 11th, 1985, Mikhail Gorbachev was selected the General Secretary of the Communist Party. 2 days later, Nixon made a surprising and unprecedented decision. He wanted to secure the taxpayers' money, and he allocated to go to the Soviet Union. He denied his Secret Service detail. And in April 1991, a few months before the Soviet Union fell on Christmas Day in December of 1991, he had a visit to Lithuania, Georgia, the Kremlin, the headquarters of the KGB, and he had praised Gorbachev as a fighter. Though this may not give any inclination as to what he might have done to come to be a part of the fall of the Soviet Union. So, now in regards to my other two links in this program that I had up, apparently they are not so good. So as I look at them, they are not so well. So when we come back here on Manny's Rockin Conspiracies, I'm going to discuss a WWE conspiracy because tonight is WrestleMania 35. Live from MetLife Stadium in New York City. Looks to be a very, very good show. The theme song to my show, which is the theme song to wrestler Zack Ryder, that's a good luck song. He is now the Raw Tag Team Champion with his tag team partner, Curt Hawkins. I am one happy Manny. That is for sure. Let me get a song queued up for you. By the way, if you have any comments on any conspiracy during this program, you're welcome to give me a call at 828-227-7173. Queued up is Paranoid by Black Sabbath. You're listening to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on WWCU FM Cullowhee 90.5.
Are you ready? You think you could tell us what to do? You think you could tell us what to wear? You think that you're better? Well, you better get ready. Bow to the masters. Break it down!
Welcome back to Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on 90.5 WWCU in Western Carolina University.
Think you can tell me what to do?
So in the last segment, since it is WrestleMania 35, there are some conspiracies about WWE, one of them involving Jim Hellwig, whom was better known as the Ultimate Warrior, whom later changed his name to just Warrior. That was just his name for a bit, was just Warrior. So let's explain. In the 80s, the Ultimate Warrior was a very, very popular, very chiseled wrestler. He main evented WrestleMania 5 in Canada, defeating Hulk Hogan for the WWE title. However, by 1991, before a match where he was teaming with Hogan at SummerSlam, he demanded a huge amount of money, or he would not compete. Vince McMahon, the owner of WWE, agreed to pay him that money. However, when Ultimate Warrior walked back after the match, he was fired. He left, and then they brought him back. But something was different about this Ultimate Warrior. He had different gear. He looked a little bit smaller. So fans began to theorize that there were two Ultimate Warriors. Now, this theory has been debunked, but it is still going around. Because if you take a look at the two Ultimate Warriors together, there is some differences. But it is possible that they are both Jim Helwig and not different people. It seems with a lot of famous people, there are all sorts of conspiracies about two different versions of them. Vladimir Putin has three, although according to my friend that was from the Soviet Union, there are 37 Putins. There were two. There was a look copy of Paul McCartney from the Beatles. Paul is dead. It seems that happens a lot to any famous person. I've realized that. But that's a little WWE conspiracy for WrestleMania 35, the grandest stage of them all. And it's getting bigger and bigger. Seth Rollins is the new WWE Universal Champion, defeating Brock Lesnar. So there is a WWE conspiracy. If you have any comments about that, why don't you give me a call at 828-227-7173. Again, 828-227-7173. Queued up is Island in the Sun by Weezer. You're listening to the craziest show in the mountains, Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies on 90.5 WWCU is Western Carolina University. This has been Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies, the craziest show in the mountains. Right now, to the computer next to me is a very odd video that CB Roy is showing me about how Florida Gulf Coast University did an April Fool's joke, and they said, we're going to name our mascot the Blobfish. And they had a student handing out, like, plush Blobfish. Well, the mascot, which is like an eagle, is not happy about the whole thing. It's a very goofy video. I'm lucky we didn't have anyone with paws, because why would we not be the Catamounts? Our April Fool's would be like, we're now the Mountain Boomers again. We're squirrels now. You're not a Catamount. We're squirrels now. Oh my goodness, it's a pyramid, it's Illuminati. This has been the craziest show in the mountains. Thank you for spending the next 2 hours with me. Thank you for spending the last 2 hours with me, whether it be about the Ultimate Warrior, there being two of them, about the CIA, or of how Illuminati made pie. Thank you for spending the past 2 hours with me. Thanks to my Uncle Phil in Florida, Chara, New Mexico, my grandmother in Fayetteville, and a whole bunch of others that are tuning into this program. Coming up next is CB Roy's Mostly Blues from 8 p.m. to 1 a.m., a show you don't want to miss. This is Manny's Rockin' Conspiracies. I'm Manny Jones, and until the next time we meet, word up, it's the code word. Have a great Sunday. I won't be here next week because I will be in Philadelphia. We'll be right back.